predicted what happened. Danny Green is there now, and Rondo's back. You basically got Pelicans West, basically, with Rondo and Boogie and AD there. And LeBron. LeBron's going to play point guard. That's pretty unstoppable in so many ways. And I just wonder
unstoppable, you think?
With LeBron at the point and AD playing the four and Boogie's. And I know Boogie is probably away from the 28-12 seasons he's had.
I don't know if he's 15-9. That's what I've been kind of. I don't know if he's 15-9.
I'm hoping for 15-9 from him.
Yeah,
I'm hoping for that for him. But when I just look at the Lakers and their size, I just can't help but think, man, if it's a 7-game series, it really could go either way, man. It's just really like the Clippers defend on an elite level, and the Lakers just got so much size. It's just something got to give, man. Something's got to give.
And you going with the Lakers?
I'm giving the Lakers a slight edge. I'm giving them a slight edge. Because, see, what folks miss about AD's game, that dude almost was a LeBron type, you know, years ago, you know, before all the injuries started happening. You could argue Anthony Davis was similar to how LeBron plays his game almost. Probably without the assist, for the most part.
Because he's a post-up. He posts.
Right. I mean, I just think they get the edge for me because it's...
Because of AD.
Because of AD. The size, Anthony Davis, LeBron at the point. He's still going to get you 25-9 or whatever. He's still going to do that. He's still going to rebound. And the Rondo factor. I think at this stage of Rondo's career, it's all about the brain at this point. And Rondo is one of the smarter players in the league. Got a ring. One of the better pure point guards that we've seen, you know, over the last few years.
Yeah.
And experience. I just think when you look at that, I think the Lakers get a slight edge.
I'm going Clippers, man.
Okay.
I'm going Clippers.
Can't go wrong with either one.
Look.
Can't go wrong.
Like, okay. Clearly.
Mm-hmm.
Anthony Davis is that dude. LeBron is that dude.
Yeah.
With that being said, I ask you this.
Mm-hmm.
When asses are tight in the fourth quarter, you going with AD or you going with Kawhi?
I'm going with Kawhi.
Sixth man, Lou Williams or whoever the hell is coming off the bench for the Lakers.
Yep.
They just have a better team, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
I've been saying this. Who's their shooters? The Lakers.
The Lakers and their shooters.
Danny Green, Caldwell Pope.
They signed him.
I mean, is he a shooter?
I don't know what else he does well. for the most part, I've seen him shoot.
Nobody on this squad says to me, when LeBron has to kick out or when AD has to get out of a double team,
right?
None of these players say, I'm going to consistently knock down that jumper.
Mm-hmm. Kuzma, we ain't even mentioned Kuzma.
Who's official. But I fear that he's going to drown in all this.
Other than AD and LeBron.
I fear that he's going to drown in it.
Productional dip.
Yeah.
No doubt about it. You think Kuzma's a guy that you give him the ball? I mean, he's not going to be like, to move out the way, but you think if you dish it to him, Kuzma going to knock that shot down?
Consistently, no.
You don't think so?
Not consistently.
Okay.
They don't have shooters, man. They don't have nobody that makes me feel like, oh, get AD out of trouble. Mm-hmm. Or LeBron, you know, sucks the defense in. You know
they signed Jared Dudley, too?
Yeah.
What's that, for toughness?
He's like,
that's basically
on.
What it's for.
Yeah. I like Quinn Cook. They got Quinn Cook. I like Quinn Cook.
Quinn Cook can shoot.
But is he that guy? Is he... He hasn't been in a position where they're going to be depending on his jumper.
Right.
Not Golden State, he hasn't. He's normally off the bench.
Mm-hmm.
When they're not expecting a whole bunch of point production.
Right. Now, how about a situation like this? I'm going to let you tell me what you think about this.